So dear student, good morning once again. As I have rightly stated during last session to you all, now we will be going to see the other aspect of section 49. Okay. So section 49, we have seen the first three and four subsection which talks about payment, adjustment, how the ITC to be adjusted, etc., etc. The next aspect which we need to learn is how the order of payment. So section 49, subsection 8. Yeah, Rushik, as per your convenience, I don't know if you have taken COVID wala thing more appropriately and you have appropriate data which will give you 200 pages, then I believe you go for the COVID wala research which has more meaning. So either KES or RISVI, it is your choice which you want to take. No problem. You have plenty of options. You have Valia College Wala also. I mean, there are many things which is there in your bucket. You have to select one. You have done a lot of work. The worry and problem with other students who are going to start now, along with remaining five subjects. For you, it won't create any problem. Well, so here there is a section 49, subsection 8. Which talks about how the order of payment, what to be paid first. Okay, if you have a liability of previous year tax also, current year tax also, or other penalties, interest, fees, etc. also, then you should first make the payment of previous year liability. Okay, say for example, you have a GST liability of this year, as well as you have GST liability of last year. So which you are going to pay first? Which you are going to pay first? Which you are going to pay first? Last year. Very correctly, Rostin. So this is as per section 49, subsection 8, it is very clearly stated, first to be paid off last year, then we should pay the current year, and finally we should make the payment of penalty, fees, interest like that. Am I clear? These are called order of payment for GST liability. Order of payment for GST liability under section 49, subsection 8. So based on this also, there could be a question, and the question will be something like this. Till here we did last time. Okay. So now the question will be like this. So write down the question and then we will look the solution aspect of it. Say for example, let me ask here only. Mr. X has 5 lakh in his electronic cash ledger. Okay. So this we will be going to set off for making the payment of liability ledger. Yes or no? As per rule 87. Yes or no? Cash ledger I am going to use to pay all this. Tax, interest, penalty. So which to be paid first? So I will pay the first payment of previous year tax, then current year tax, then interest, then this, if at all we have available balance. Am I very clear to you all? So this is your question, which is specifying you have 5 lakh in your cash ledger of X Limited. And these are the liabilities. Tax liability of CGST, IGST, UTGST, SGST for supplies made during August 2017. Okay. Only you can change the year. For you, the question will be 2020. Other things will remain as it is. Okay. So you have a tax liability of August 2017. Okay. You have an interest again belong to August 2017. You have a taxable liability for September 2017. You have interest penalty and return for September 2017, and there was a demand raise under section 40, section 73 and 74 of 2000 CGST Act 2017 belonging to July 2017, and demand raise as per provision of indirect taxes. So which to be paid in what sequence is important. Interest to be paid first, or liability to be paid first, or last year to be paid first, likewise. Okay. And then we will see the order of payment. Kindly take down the question first. I hope the question is visible to you all. Take down, then we will go for solution. Anjali and Rushik, you try with your own as you have completed the question. What to be written when? You know the provision. This is there with you, section 49, subsection 8. Based on that, apply your logic and try to get the answer. Others, you can write down the question first and then we will discuss the solution. You are not deserving to give certain freedom. I have allowed you to unmute and give your answers, not anything else. I'm not allowed to disturb other students. Okay, fine. If you have completed, just let me know. I got only the feedback from two students. What about other students? We have almost 45 students. Still they are writing. Those who have mentioned that they have done, they can get me their answers also, because only 5 students I am finding they have given me answer that they have completed this question. So you can continue with answering. Yeah, 6 students also. But now you can start solving, no? I want you to do error. So that you can remember forever, these were my errors, these were my mistakes, you will never repeat again. Let other student finish, then I will display the slide of the solution. What answer you are getting? Sunita, Meghna, Guria, Sakshi, Nipun, Yash, Rushik and Anjali. What is your answer? Kindly put your answers also. Meghna, this doubt I cannot give you explanation now, because then others will get a hint. But yes, Rushik got me the right answer. Very correct. Only Rushik has got the answer. What about other students? Okay, let me give the hint of Meghna's doubt also. As these are the previous demand of indirect tax, they are not pertaining to GST. Okay, whereas section 49 subsection 8 very particularly stating about GST. So we will not consider until unless we'll make the payment of all this. I hope your doubt is clear, Meghna. Thank you, Uta. So we do not have much time. We have to show your answers also for a little bit while. This is the last. No. There won't be single penny for payment. 30,40,000 aayega kahan se? Kahin nahi hai wo figure. इसी 5 लाख में से अपने को वापरना है. Am I right, Rushik? The 5 lakh what we have in cash ledger, that only we can utilize for paying off these liabilities and taxes. Yes or no? And after paying, if we do have certain balance, we'll keep it. If it is not there, there is nil balance. But Rushik has very rightly got me the answer. The answer is here. This is your answer, dear student. Discharge of tax liability under section 49, subsection 8. Whatever we have in cash ledger, and only Rushik has given me correct answer. We have utilized to the extent what we had 5 lakh remaining to be paid subsequently. By putting further balance into cash ledger, either electronic transfer, NEFT, net banking. Okay. So you must have seen, first we paid the old tax of August. Then subsequent tax of September, then old interest, then subsequent interest. These are the fees and penalties. Section 73 and 74 is for fees and penalties. So after making all these payments, we do not have any balance. Still many things to be paid. It can be paid after having cash balance in cash ledger. Kindly take down your answer, please. So that is what here it is very clearly mentioned. If and now I will put the balance in cash ledger first, 5,60,000 to be paid. And then old demand which is raised. Because that is as per the provision of different previous act, not GST. Next week again we will have few more practical question based on this discharge of liability under section 49 subsection 8, and then we can, after that we can move to next topic. I hope everyone has taken this answer, because 4 videos are on, they have completed their answer. I can make out. So see you next week on Tuesday and Wednesday. Wednesday or the tomorrow again we have lecture, no? Not wrong, yes. Wednesday and Thursday.